John Sweeney is by no means a fan favorite in Boston. Despite bringing in popular names like Taylor Hall and Hampus Lindholm, he also brought in guys like Andre Kasha, John Moore, and Nick Foligno. He has set us up in a pretty bad cap situation and a scary overall future for the entire team, but there are some very positive rumors coming out of this offseason, and there is a scenario where he can maybe make everything right. The Bruins are currently at $2.38 million in cap space, and that's without Patrice Bergeron signed. It's been a sure thing he's probably coming back on a one-year deal, and I have no clue what kind of money he's going to accept, but with the rumor that David Krejci might also be looking to return, I don't see how he can take anything less than a major discount. Now, this isn't the order that it would happen in, but let's say Bergeron and Krejci do return to the Bruins this season, I don't think I'm crazy in saying that would probably cost us around $3 or $4 million. That would put the Bruins at minus $1.62 million in cap debt. Now, I understand Bergeron and Krejci for $4 million is insane, but it's because of their age that you can pay them less on the books and more in bonus salary. Them both signing for around $2 million and being paid $4 million more in bonuses is likely how Sweeney can get these contracts done. But we'd still be in cap debt, so obviously Sweeney would need to make some moves to give us cap space. Starting off with the buyout of Nick Foligno. He was a great signing on paper, but once he stepped on the ice, he was completely useless. Buying out his contract would give us an extra $1.9 million, leaving us at a measly $300K in cap space. Now, you obviously need to fill his spot in the lineup. A league minimum rookie contract of $750,000 would do the trick, but that's back to minus $450,000 on the cap. Still some work to be done, and that's fine, because we have too many left-shot defensemen after bringing in Lindholm at the deadline and signing Jakob Zboril early this offseason. You could trade away a few guys, but the likely option is Mike Rielly, a guy who would give you a late draft pick in return and take off $3 million from our cap. Let's say that deal does get done, and now we're in the green at $2.55 million. It's worth noting at this point, starting the season without McAvoy, Marchand, or Grzelcyk due to offseason surgeries could garner the team an extra $20 million to spend if all of them landed on long-term injury reserve. That is an unlikely scenario to put all three on the list, but I think it's safe to say we could see one or two of them on the list, and that would allow us to have some wiggle room in our cap. The scenario of putting Marchand and McAvoy both on LTIR for 2 or 3 months would grant us $15 million in cap space. I genuinely believe Don Sweeney can and might do this, because other than the guys I've already mentioned, that would allow us to sign Bergeron and Krejci without removing anyone else from the lineup and maybe even adding more players. Now, obviously, once both of those key players in Marchand and McAvoy come back, you're looking at a tough situation of needing to dump one or more players in order to be cap compliant. Guys like DeBrusk at $4 million, Erik Haula at $2.3 million, Craig Smith could be on the block at $3.1 million, or even an overpaid Charlie Coyle at $5.25 million could all be on the outs if you need to create more cap space later or to start the season. I'm fine with trading these guys if it means we're getting those precious draft picks back and prospects that Don Sweeney has carelessly traded away over the years. That would basically mean we're flipping a lot of our roster, but that seems like an inevitable situation that this team faces in the years to come. You can also say the plan makes no sense because even though the Bruins will get some return on those players, teams know that in order for us to be cap compliant, we would have to get rid of those guys and they could offer us less in return knowing that. If Krejci doesn't return, this scenario is a whole lot easier because you don't have to worry about trading our centers like Coyle, Haula, or Nosek. If Krejci does come back, I don't see any way that you can keep all five players at center without at least dumping one or two wingers, maybe Omark at goalie or even somebody on defense. Our new head coach, Jim Montgomery, was hired knowing that he's great with younger players, and we're going to have to start trusting those younger guys for depth if we're bringing these big names back. At the end of the day, I'm not a general manager of the NHL, nor am I Don Sweeney. It might take the wave of a magic wand, but I think somehow, some way, he's going to get the band back together, and we're going to run it back and try to win our Stanley Cup. So to recap everything and give my prediction for the major moves being made as early as July 13th when free agency opens, Bergeron and Krejci return as 1 and 2C for roughly $2 million each, with millions more in bonuses on their deals. Mike Rielly gets traded for future considerations or a very late draft pick, which allows us to get $3 million off our books. Sweeney has mentioned no buyouts, but I think under a new coach, we need younger guys in the lineup, and that means a contract buyout of Nick Foligno needs to happen. And finally, one of Erik Haula or Craig Smith get dealt in order to free more cap space, and maybe we can even get a semi-decent return for one of them. One last thing of major note this offseason is to sign David Pastrnak to a max extension. Throw whatever money he wants at him. Pasta needs to be a Bruin for his whole career. If Sweeney can't get this deal done, then he's in for one painful media frenzy. Today is July 12th, so free agency opens tomorrow, and I wouldn't doubt if contracts are already being agreed upon, and we can know a lot more about this Bruin Bruins team in just a short few days.